Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to take a look at a battery drain issue on a 2006 Volkswagen Jetta. Keeps going dead. People let it sit for, you know, 3 or 4 days. And we're going to see if we can diagnose, see what the issue is, and figure out if we can stop it. And I don't know, see what's going on. Let's get started. A little bit of backstory. Earlier this summer, since it never seems to rain here, I left the windows down. Stupid me. Anyways, it rained. Not just a little, a lot. Straight line winds, about 80 miles an hour. Both windows open. Car had about an inch of water on the floorboards when I got back. So, anyways, fairly certain it's something in the interior. But we're gonna go through the steps to diagnose it and see if we can find it, troubleshoot it. Probably won't be able to fix it tonight because I'm fairly certain I know what it is, and I don't have one laying around. So, let's get going. So, here we're at, the battery. This guy, never seen one? That's what it looks like. Anyways, normally it has a cover on it, mine doesn't. Didn't come with one, and I don't really care. But, normally, you would test this battery. Should have a little over 12 volts. I'm fairly certain this one's less, just because I've left this plugged in for a couple days. So we'll test it, just to kind of show you what's going on. So, backlight. Anyways, got this set up in 20 DC. One, like I say, it should have about 12 plus. We're gonna be short, I know we are. Yep, 11.86. Now is 11.8 or whatever that said. Not going to start this car. The car will start with that. Not much lower, but it'll start with that. I know the battery's good because it's newer and I've tested it before, and trust me, the car got rain in it, okay? And so anyways, we're going to pull off the negative terminal and we're going to put the multimeter, we're going to reconfigure it, put it in line with the ground. So therefore, any draw will have to go through the multimeter. So let's get that set up. So first thing on the multimeter, we're going to want to switch this guy over here. And then we're going to want to go to 10, right? Yeah, 10. And then we're going to take off the terminal. It happens to be a 10 millimeter. Mileage may vary. Yours may or may not be. That's what it happens to be. Really? All right. Over there, and let's get something to connect those two. Since I don't have bigger hands, that's not tight enough at all. Okay, really? Go to your home. Positive, probably a bad deal, huh? Damn, this is, yeah, it shouldn't be doing that, by the way. Okay. There. So we've got this hooked up, and as you can see, 1.5. And it fluctuates bad. Something's going on. Now, there's nothing on in the car. There's no lights on. So when you start this project, make sure everything's off in your car. The doors are shut, everything. Your computer will draw some, but it should probably be like point something, not whatever that is. So we definitely have a draw. We're going to start pulling fuses. We're going to start on the engine side because a lot of times, if it's out here, great. You don't have to go look in there. And vice versa. So let's do that. This one, plain of the fuse box. This one happens to be right here. All right, here's the fuses. We're gonna pull these fuses one by one until this changes. Now, you might, nope, nothing. So we're just gonna keep going through them all. It helps if you pull out your owner's manual, or a lot of times it's written on the back side of this. Mine's not, it's in the owner's manual. I happen to know that this fuse over here, right here, is, oh, look at that, 0.82. Huh. So it's still going on, but I would consider that acceptable for the time being. So we know there's a problem in number 15. Or in this fuse location, this 15 amp fuse. So let's go pull up the manual, see what it is. All right, so I've located the fuse description in the owner's manual. And if I look around, okay, we'll figure out, this is the fuse box we want, 35 fuse, F815. Oh, look, I don't know if you guys can see that. It says radio. So, more than likely, when it got wet inside, it shorted out the radio. So we're gonna disconnect the radio and see if I leave that fuse in, if we get the same drop in voltage that we had before. Or draw, I should say. Well, welcome to my office for the next 10 or 15 minutes. So typically, since this one, it did actually say that that fuse is specifically for the radio. I have had it in other vehicles where it doesn't. It's a bigger fuse, and what it is either a fuse or a relay to the fuse panel in the cabin here. And then if that's the case, you just repeat the process. You move to here, start pulling fuses, hopefully you isolate it down to something like, you know, a seat motor or, I don't know, light, who knows, but that's what you figure out. But you gotta remember now that we have the doors open, that draw is gonna go up because this light is on. So this radio has four screws in it after we get everything else off. But before we pull those, you're gonna wanna make sure that if you have a disc changer, you get your discs out. Cause that will be bad. Oh. I should probably put the fuse in.
Bring it.
Fuse back. Okay. Round two. Yeah, eject. It's gonna be a hot minute. What is it now? 55? Huh. What are they on now? 180? I'm not even gonna acknowledge that one. Homemade. Sure, it's just a copy, a backup. Another copy. Huh. Garth Brooks. Sevens. Garth Brooks Live at the Big Apple. Course. All right, let's get this out. Moving screws again. Steering was horribly in the way. Guessing a nut driver would be a better choice. I didn't have one. I did have this though. That's what I'm using. Left the radio on. The downside is, no, this, it's got to be the radio. I'm betting climate control. It's like a sensor's kicking off. I don't know. It might disconnect climate control too. Just see. It is digital, and the one side is shorted out. Not that kind of short. The LCD thing doesn't work. Okay, this should pull right out. Okay. Ah, we got it. Okay, now let's get this thing disconnected. Off of there. Not coming off of there. Anyway, let's get those off. Oh, look, there's clips on the back. That would have been easier instead of ripping them apart. Note to self, solder that together. Super glue. This is a video on how to find a short, not how to unwire a radio. Okay, so we got some magical clip on it. Looks like it's gonna fight me. Radio appears to be on again. Don't understand. Oh, there it went. Okay. Aha! Got it. Got it out. Okay. Well, I went back and forth a few times, plugged it in, tested it a few more times, and it is the radio, unfortunately for me. And like I said in the beginning, I'm not going to be able to fix this because I don't have that radio. Another one of those. And I didn't know. If you've ever owned a Volkswagen, I'll tell you what it stands for. I don't know what it stands for, but it's Germans' response to losing the war. That's why they created these cars. Very specific, everything's based off the VIN number, serial number, and even then, it's wrong 50% of the time. So, especially on these older ones, this is a half year, so it's kind of half parts from that year, half parts of that one, and you don't really know where you stand until you actually physically have it in your hand, which is what I just did tonight. So, I'll get serial numbers off of that, and we'll get a new one installed, and we should be good to go. But, to show you where we ended up on the power, so, this is after letting it settle out for a little bit. 0.33. That's probably just your computer staying alive. But again, like I said, that's gonna wrap it up for this project. Like I said, I can't go any further with this one. I just wanted to kind of show you how to find, isolate, narrow down electrical problem. And it's pretty much as simple as a voltmeter on the battery. You can also, another way to do it, is you can go through every fuse with your leads and touch on every single one and see which one's got current going through it. Because everything's shut off, there should be almost no current going through anything anywhere, like I said, except VCM. Or another thing to watch out for, if you got your hood open while you're doing it, dome light under the, hood light will cause that. So anyways, guys, hey, appreciate it. Help grow the channel, smash the like, subscribe button, and we'll see you on the next project.